see. This is Brad, H2Vinyl. This video, I want to talk a little bit more about the bulk buys that I did in 2015. Kind of diving into those today and picked out five records that I've listened to throughout this week. And whether I like them, whether I'll keep them, or whether I will decide to probably discard them or sell them. Not really sure yet. But anyway, let's get into the first album. I'm going to do some needle drops because I enjoy doing those and share kind of the music instead of having people go to other YouTube videos and Spotify, getting a little bit of feel for what that the music is right away. So anyway, the first album up is Blood, Sweat, and Tears, their greatest hits album. This was released in 1972 originally, but the quadraphonic version was released in November 1973. This is blues rock, classic rock, a little bit of psych in there as well. This copy is, I really enjoyed this. This is the first copy that I found of anything Blood, Sweat, and Tears, and the first copy that I listened to, and it kind of gave a good overall feel for what the band has done in the past, and really enjoyed it. This copy is in really poor condition. It repeat skips several times on side two, so I probably won't be playing anything from side two. I decided on keeping not this version in the collection. I'll have it there temporarily as a placeholder. I've got four ratings basically on whether I keep or sell vinyl out of what I have, and one is keep, the second one is sell, the third one is kind of a fence where I need to spin it a few more times to make a decision, and then the other one is placeholder, and that placeholder is just there to say, hey, I like this, make sure I get a better copy, and I'll look for one. I hope to put all of this stuff in a database and then basically be able to pull up all the placeholder albums in a couple of seconds, and then be able to, you know, just kind of go through that list slowly and replace them. Great pickup, and I'll definitely keep that one in the collection and hope to find a better copy.
Down in a crap game, I've been losing at roulette. Cards are bound to break me, but I ain't busted yet. Cause I've been called a natural lover by that lady over there. Honey, I'm just a natural gambler, but I try to do my share. Go down gambling. Say it when you're running low. Go down gambling.
The second album that I want to talk about is the Thompson Twins. This is their 1985 album, Here's to the Future Days, or Here's to Future Days. This also includes, as you can see right there, there's a hype sticker on the front of the actual cover. This includes the remix, which is a completely another LP. This is on the Artisa label. As I mentioned before, this is 1985. They're kind of a synth-pop band. And this is what I kind of found confusing. This is, I think, their seventh album. Their first album was released in 1981, so it's kind of interesting to have seven studio albums in 4 years. That's about an album every 9 months. Maybe they had just a lot of material that or maybe it really didn't take much to get all that material. I don't know. But for the most part, I really enjoyed. I'm a sucker for 80s synth pop, new wave, kind of the Cars and Duran Duran. I definitely wouldn't say this topped those two. This is 1985, so it came out just before I kind of got big into hip-hop. Kind of got into hip-hop 85, 86, and then started to slowly make the transition to listening to hip hop exclusively, and that pretty much started in 88. Yeah, I have this down as a placement hold. And so this placement copy will, if I can find this for cheap and a better copy, I think I've marked this down as very good. If I can find a better copy, I'll pick it up. The third album is Roy Orbison's 1989 album, Mystery Girl. This is on the Virgin label. Roy Orbison is really not my cup of tea. I'm not a huge fan of rock and roll, the 50s type rock and roll. Not a big collector of Elvis. And I don't really care for soft rock either. I kind of like the classic hard rock metal. This is a very good copy, and I've marked this on the fence. Fence meaning I'm not 100% certain if it's really going to stay in my collection. I need to listen to it a few times, but the truth is, if it stays in my collection, since you know rock and roll and soft rock aren't my default genre to go to, this will not get played very much. Album that I've listened to from the bulk buys is Pat Travers Band, Crash and Burn. This is their third studio album from 1980, and this is on the Polydor label. This is actually the first I heard of Pat Travers Band. It's blues rock, kind of classic rock. I really enjoyed this. I've decided to keep. The copy is decent. I would say it's still very good. If I do find a better copy, I will definitely pick it up. One thing about this, the first side is great. I just listened to it before making this video, and all of the songs, like Born Under the Bad Sign, Snortin' Whiskey, Crash and Burn, which is the title track, I really liked all of them. But as the album went on, side two gets a little weak toward the end. Probably won't listen to the last two tracks very often. Side one is absolutely incredible. A lot of fun. I'll probably play something from the first side. All of that information will be on the needle drop. But I definitely enjoyed this, and this is definitely a keeper for me. Fifth album, the final album that I want to mention today, is Johnny Winter, Still Alive and Well. This is his 1973 album. This is his fifth studio album on Columbia, the Columbia label. I didn't know much about Johnny Winter. I thought he was a part of a group before, but I was wrong. He signed up for Columbia, I believe in 1969, and I believe it was a $300,000 label deal with them. That the rest is history, basically. when I, like I said, I haven't listened to Johnny Winter. Though I've seen him in the used section several times, I never really picked up any of his stuff. And so I was really glad to find this in a bulk, in the, my bulk buy. And I'm like, oh, good. I already have a copy. I can listen to something from him. And right off the bat, I could tell the talent that he has. I think Wikipedia said something like he was just a musical prodigy. And that really does stand out. He's got, you know, the genre of kind of a blues rock artist. And I really like blues rock. This is a rough copy, very rough copy. Side two actually repeat skips, so I definitely won't be playing anything from that. But tracks that, pretty much all of the first side, Rock Me Baby, Can't You Feel It, All Torn Down, Rock and Roll, Still Alive and Well, and Let It Bleed are ones that stand out for me. Which is 3/4 of the album. I'm definitely going to look for a better copy. Like, this is one where I probably would pay a decent amount of money. Because as you can see, this has writing on the front. It has really heavy ring wear. And the vinyl scratched up horribly as well. But I'm really glad to have this, and will definitely be looking for another copy of it. So here's the needle drop. You know I'm all told down. I'm all told down, yeah. Somebody tell the world to stop or just slow down. VC, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you enjoyed the music and the needle drops. If any of this stuff is new to you, please let me know. I enjoy, really what I want these videos to do is help other people discover new music. And because that's what I want to do from everyone else's videos. And so I'm constantly listening to Spotify after seeing many videos, and I try and post. I never knew about that artist. So, and I love to read those comments as well. If you do have any info about any of these artists, please let me know. If you want to try and change my mind on Roy's album, if you really love it, tell me why. I'll take that into consideration. I hope you're having a great day and a great week, and we will talk to you next time.